On Diary of the Dark Bikers Randy, we look at randonauting. How does it work? It's based on quantum mechanics and dodgy people from the dark web, if you ask me. The app generates a pin, a location for you to go explore. You give your location your intent, hit anomaly void, attractor or pseudo. Look at what people have found. This poor girl watches a man die at the side of the road, literally dying in his wife's arms. People find bodies, it's real and potentially dangerous. 1. Think hard of your intent. Hit the button and then go to that location. Best to do with others and on your own, but the choice is yours. If you want to learn more, look at my last video, Peaks on Quantum Mechanics and Quantum Physics in Correlation and Relation to Randonautica. These poor teens used the app on their TikTok. It led them to this location where they discovered a suitcase. Sadly and frightening, it was body parts. Yep, that's right, national news, body parts. Right, okay. Just waiting for some traffic to go past. There we go. Randonauting. What is randonaut and what is randonauting? If you don't know, please go check out my last video. It will explain everything to you. So today, there it is mounted. So first location, bit of a bust. Check out my fantastic helmet. Took me to Penbrick Court. Penbrick. Randonauting with me. If you do not know what randonauting is, then you have been living under a rock, you've been hiding behind trees, or you just haven't been keeping up with YouTube or TikTok. It has been blasting everywhere, all over social media, not so much on Instagram, more on YouTube. If you don't know what randonauting is, go back, link to this in the description below to my last video where we talked about quantum physics and quantum mechanics in relation to this app. Now, unfortunately, my GoPro has stopped working temporarily, but it's okay, we're gonna sort it. We just need a new battery. So what I'm gonna do is screen record the randonauting app. Okay, so the next bit that's gonna come up on the screen is gonna be the map. We're gonna set our intent, aren't we, Mum?
Intent?
Yeah, we've got to set our intent.
Intent? Oh.
Yeah, like I said, we've got to think of something, yes. Like before we start the journey.
Yes.
Before we start the journey, she's dying to get off. So before we start the journey, we have to think of something together. So for the audience's sake, we're going to say this out loud, because I'm not even running the Randonaut app, okay? So it can't listen in, can it, at the minute? So our first intent, Mum, should we have a good experience?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
Do you want to think, should we think of a colour? Should we think of...
Okay, blue.
Blue?
Yes.
Okay, there we go. Okay, so our intent for our first location is the colour blue. So we'll see you guys soon. Hey guys, Kaz Van D here with Diary of the Dark, rocking the mask today as I am riding around with my mother. Rocking it. My mother has decided that she will come randonauting with me. If you do not know what randonauting is, then you have been living under a rock, you've been hiding behind trees, or you just haven't been keeping up with YouTube or TikTok. It has been blasting everywhere, all over. Here's the app. I was using a screen recorder at the time, so just bear with me. So I pressed attractor, ANU, it generated us a pin, went onto maps, loaded it up on maps. The location that we're at the moment is just a random location we just pulled over and decided that was where we were going to start doing our randonaut. So from the map you can see that it has generated a pin. I do believe it is only a... I think it was a 3 to 5 minute journey. apologize. Yeah, I have a new phone and was using the screen recording app. I think, oh yeah, it went wrong the first time, so we had to go back on it again.
Mother doesn't want to be on camera, but she's here.
Right, so literally the pinpoint is just over here, and there's a blue car. We said blue, we manifested blue, we had our intent was blue. Can you believe it? The pinpoint is over here.
It's not the car,
because
it's
mobile. There's a blue garage. Here you go. Look. Blue car, blue garage door. This was the pinpoint in this area here. This was the pinpoint, this area. This is where we pulled up. We had to come around because we were on the wrong side of the road. So, and then we had to come back over here. Blue garage door, blue car. What do you think, Mum? You're not on camera. But what do you think? Yeah, but put your voice on.
Yeah, it's okay.
Our intent was blue.
It was blue. Showed us a blue.
A blue garage.
Blue garage.
But they're all white. All garages are white.
Yes. Yeah.
And there's one blue garage.
Yeah, it is a bit unusual. And a blue car outside.
And the blue car, and there's another blue car just over there. And now a blue truck. So guys, that was our first randonaut for the day. We did press a tractor. We wanted to see something nice. We went for the colour blue. Just so happened that the location gave us a blue garage with a blue car. So yeah, that was a pretty nice experience. See you soon. So guys, it is a really hot day today. It is like 32 degrees. Celsius. I'm sweating under the mask. I couldn't put any makeup on today because it just drips right off me, so I do apologize. I've had a bit of a haircut, but yeah, I do apologize for the state of myself at the moment. Sorry guys. But yeah, okay, listen, so our first intent was an attractor and it was the color blue. Out of all the garages there was one blue garage with one blue car outside. Now I've been on about 20 randonauts and I've not really come across much, to be honest. This is the first time that anything is correlated to what we were trying to manifest. So our next intention, we're going to go for void. Right? We're going to go for void, and our intention is going to be something creepy. We want to see something creepy. That's our intention. God, I look bloody awful. I'm sorry, guys. Yeah, that is our intention. Something creepy. So we are going to do a 3-mile radius from where we are. Just Mum's lovely car. Check out the ink, guys. Comfortably numb. God, I love Floyd. So yeah, we're just at Morrison's at the minute picking up a barbecue, as we were going to have one at my folks' house, but my dad's not feeling very well and I was a little bit worried that he might have something serious, so I need to see how he goes. So we decided to cancel the barbecue, but myself and my partner, we're going to have one at home this afternoon. This is our last randonaut now. We're going to go do two today because I'm feeling a bit tired. It's a bit too hot and my mum's feeling a bit tired too. So we're going to do two today. We're going to go for something creepy and we're going to go void. So guys, it is a really hot day today. It is like 32 degrees Celsius. I'm sweating under the mask. I couldn't put any makeup on today because it just drips right off me, so I do apologize. I've had a bit of a haircut, but yeah, I do apologize for the state
of myself at the moment. Sorry, guys. But yeah, okay, listen. So our first intent was an attractor, and it was the colour blue. Out of all the garages there, there was one blue garage with one blue car outside. Now, I've been on about 20 randonauts, and I've not really come across much, to be honest. This is the first time that anything is correlated to what we were trying to manifest. So our next intention, we're going to go for void. Right? We're going to go for void, and our intention is going to be something creepy. We want to see something creepy. That's our intention. God, I look bloody awful. I'm sorry, guys. Yeah, that is our intention. Something creepy. So we are going to do a 3-mile radius from where we are. Just mum's lovely car. Check out the ink, guys. Comfortably numb. God, I love Floyd. So yeah, we're just at Morrison's at the minute picking up a barbecue, as we were going to have one at my folks' house, but my dad's not feeling very well, and I was a little bit worried that he might have something serious, so I need to see how he goes. So we decided to cancel the barbecue, but myself and my partner, we're going to have one at home this afternoon. This is our last randonaut now. We're going to go do two today, because I'm feeling a bit tired. It's a bit too hot, and my mum's feeling a bit tired too. So we're going to do two today. We're going to go for something creepy, and we're going to go void. Okay, mum doesn't want to be on camera, but can you tell them, mum, what our intent is now? What did we think of?
Spooky.
Spooky, something creepy.
Creepy.
Okay, all right. So start the maps. Oh. Okay, mum doesn't want to be on camera, but can you tell them, mum, what our intent is now? What did we think of?
Spooky.
Spooky, something creepy.
Creepy.
Okay, all right. So start the maps. Oh. Okay, mum doesn't want to be on camera, but can you tell them, mum, what our intent is now? What did we think of?
Spooky.
Spooky, so, something creepy.
We gave the GPS our coordinates. It asked us for anomaly, attractor, or void. I pressed void. Sorry, I do apologise, my phone lagging slightly. Asked me ANU or temporal. I went with ANU, Australian National University. Think hard about our intent, mother and I. Did it came up really quickly, which I was surprised at. We were going for something creepy. So now I'm generating maps any minute now. My screen record should move on to maps. There we go. Rocket like a pocket, and it has generated our pin. I'm slightly gutted that I haven't actually got the film footage of the journey there, and I apologise for doing this very poor attempt of a voiceover, but I wanted to prove that we were actually going to the places that it said, you know, said to us, because I do believe there are randonauts out there that go to the location, they film it on their maps, showing the location, sometimes showing not too much of the location, sometimes showing all the location. When I show all of the location, you know, it's more respect, like, because you could see if anybody was planting things. But, you know, because I don't believe it all, do you? Start a discussion. Do you believe all that happens on YouTube with people finding dead bodies and weird voodoo things and Dibbit boxes, like Jodie from Hunting the Dead? That Dibbit box was planted. It basically looked like one of his. If you haven't seen Jodie's video, check out Hunting the Dead. Look at the one when he goes randonauting. It's like 1 minute it wasn't there, the next minute it's just suddenly there. Like, somebody would leave a Dibbit boxes, believe me. I deal with a lot of Dibbit boxes
There's no chance it would be out just in the wilderness, in the bit of tall grass somewhere, hanging around waiting for somebody for it to be picked up. It would have been picked up a hell of a long time ago. That was a plant. Anyway, back to the map. We are heading towards our destination still. Not too far away now, coming up to it. RANDONAUTING. I ride a motorbike, right? A very, very, very nice motorbike. And for me, I have to obviously screen record my maps and try and use my cheaper version of a GoPro, which doesn't seem to be working properly at the minute. It's like it's turning on, recording for a bit, and turning off. It doesn't matter how long I charge the battery for, this is happening. So I'm thinking I might need to save a little bit of money and buy an upgrade for that. Also, it doesn't have night vision on, so if I was doing a night job, I'm going to have to get myself a decent camcorder. If you'd like to send me any donations, please, towards a camcorder, then my gratefulness will be upon you forever. Just ask me to email you. Even if it's £4.25 so I can go and grab a Starbucks. So, shameless plug in there. I don't even have a channel for donations, so a little bit of a joke there. God, we're slowly getting to this destination, aren't we? I wish we'd hurry up and just get there. All the time we were going along this road, we kept thinking, creepy, 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 something creepy. And it was sending us towards like this area that it sends me to quite a bit, which is called Whitby Park. Sends me up towards there. Or it'll send me down Old Sites Road, which is just this one long road of like industrial buildings and like waste, big massive waste funnel things, and a lot of it you need passes to get through, and where I needed to go I couldn't get through, it was all barricaded. There's no point me showing these things on YouTube, it's boring, you don't want to see it, you know, they're busts. But for some reason it sends me there quite a lot when I'm on my own. The minute I'm in the car with my mother, we get decent places like housing estate, and the place, I don't know, you know, we'll find out soon once we get there what the place is like when we get there. Let's see if it's creepy or not. But I suppose it is possible to find things. Find like Wiccan things, huts in woods, symbols in woods and things, because there is a lot of people out there who do practice in voodoo or black magic or Wicca, witchcraft, you know, things like that, and they normally hang around in woods and stuff. So if it sends you to the woods, you're more than likely going to bump into something. But if it sends you to the woods and you start hearing voices, then well, I think you should just get the heck out of there. Me, I'd have trouble because when I'm outside of the house, even though I'm on a motorbike, when I'm not on a motorbike I can't walk very far. I could probably walk a couple of minutes and then I have to stop because I have problems with my legs. I have done since I was a kid, and I also have spine problems, 3 slip discs on top of everything else too. So I struggle when I'm out and about, which is why you see a lot of these videos done at home. But I was happy that Mum wanted to go RANDONAUTING because I could sit in the passenger seat for a while, chill out, be in charge of the map, where we're going. She didn't have a clue, she's not from around this area. So we were chatting in the car though, and we were thinking about going, me riding down there to where my mum lives, so I'm not going to say where she lives, but where my mum lives, and maybe doing some RANDONAUTING videos around there, because it's just pure like farmers fields, there's like loads of graveyards, churches, this is the Commonwealth graveyard, there's you got the mile, the warp mile, there's lots of land there, there's lots of places, there's the ice cream farm, Damn it. And it doesn't matter, there's ice cream farms all over the place. There's an ice cream farm, yeah, there's a candle factory, there's all up in the hills. So, I mean, you could find some really quite crazy things up there. So maybe I should, when the weather's good, in for a good week next week. Apparently the weather's going to be 19, 20, 23, 26, 27 degrees by the weekend. 20, quite strong on Friday, I think. Saturday, Sunday, Monday and Tuesday. So I might take a little wander down there. I have been meaning to film actually in one of the churchyard graveyards there, where there is a pirate's grave. I wouldn't mind doing some EMF, EVPs and maybe a spirit box session down there. If you guys would like to see that, please leave a comment below just saying, yep, Kaz, go for it. There's a lot of history with it. I'm sure we'd get some activity. And it's a video again where I'm outside when I'm not in the house doing divot boxes. I mean, I love doing divot boxes. I love getting them. I love the fear. My heart trembling as it does. Beeps, I tell you what, it beeps and beeps and beeps when I open those boxes and pull out some of the stuff. And the worst thing is, either not knowing what stuff means and then being obviously frightened because you don't know, or have a really good understanding and knowledge of it and know exactly what it is and be frightened of it for a very good reason, because you know what that reason is. And that reason isn't normally or necessarily very good. So we're taking our time here. Just want to be breaking any speed limits. Actually, you can see the speed that she's going. So you can see that we're not breaking any speed limits there. Well done, Mum. She is 75 and she is still rocking and rolling and riding around. And it looks like we've come to the location. So there we are. So I've got to get out the car now and walk over to where that pin area is. We can't necessarily park over there, we just pulled up, can't park over there, so I'm gonna have to get out. Mum and I were just having a chat about what we should do and if it was worth doing a video or not. I said, yeah, look, you know, not every location is a success. Why not show some busts? And I've not really heard many people slagging off Randonautica, neither. People are all like, oh yeah, it's true. TikTok, they found bodies and suitcases and some really annoying people from the UK. I'm not going to mention them, they just do my head in. I think they fake a lot of stuff. I tell you what, should be called Faking Demons. There is a channel called Faking Demons, by the way. But Preview Demons with Andrew, watch his shit. I'm telling you something, he manipulates his friends around him to believe in his bullshit. He definitely hides things, he drops things and pretends he finds them. And I mean, he was on BBC News not so long ago last year, putting a bone in a wall and going through the wall, discovering it and saying it was human. The police, the ID got called out, medical, they found out in the end it was just a prop. And he was responsible for that. So, don't know why he's got 200,000-300,000 fans when he's a complete and utter faker just because his videos are entertaining. I'm not going to start bullshitting. Excuse my French. But because people need to know the truth, and they're not going to be knowing the truth if people are wandering around faking videos. Anyway, enough on that subject, it just really pissed me off. I do watch his videos, because I go back and I think, nah, I caught you out there. Anyway, speak to you guys soon.